Hi everyone, my name is Luella Gaskell. I am a junior double majoring in supply chain management and finance, and my presentation is titled ISU YAF, Present Members on the Past. In the course of learning about the archives and looking for a presentation topic, I was excited to come across some articles about a club that I've belonged to for over a year now. The club is Young Americans for Freedom, or YAF, and it is a conservative club here on campus. This current chapter was only created in the last couple years, so I was very surprised to find Iowa State Daily articles about the club that were dated in the 70s and the 90s. The two articles I will be sharing with you all today talk about the club's purpose on campus, as well as some of the current issues and projects they were involved in at the time. The first article I will be sharing today has a title that's a bit of an oxymoron. The article was published February 18, 1991, written by Jennifer Wilson, and it is titled, Hardcore Conservatives Form Campus YAF. The article goes into the purpose of the club itself and some of the club's involvement, including support of the Persian Gulf War and a legal case against race-based scholarships. It lists some of the YAF activities, including fundraisers, distributing literature such as the group's official magazine, New Guard, attending rallies, and even sending members to DC for a national convention. I also shared these articles with some current members and was able to include some of their comments. This is a quote from the ISU YAF president in 1991, Greg Fetterman, and our current club president, Chuck Klapatowski's thoughts on it. We are a conservative organization. Basically, what we do is say what the college Republicans or Republican groups can't say because of political ties. We're not constrained by party politics. I think that statement is so interesting because it was one of the focal reasons we restarted the YAF chapter 2 years ago. We were frustrated by the conservative voices on campus and wanted to create a group that didn't limit what our club members could advocate for or speak on. I think our club embodies those values today, and it is refreshing to see that those have been held throughout history. The next article I will share today is titled, YAF Dedicated to Maintaining Rights of Each Individual. It was published on May 7, 1973, and was written by Deanne Veenschoten. This article also talks about the purpose of the club itself, as well as some of the reasons that members chose to join the club, such as the opportunity to meet prominent political figures such as Vice President Spiro Agnew and discuss topics with people who, quote, simply want the conservative point of view. The article also discusses some of the projects they were involved in at the time, such as striking against amnesty, selling bracelets in support of prisoners of war in Vietnam, and working to abolish mandatory student fees. Their efforts regarding student fees was the topic of my next quote from Chuck. It is so refreshing to hear that YAF has been invested in this in the past because it shows YAF has and continues to be the voice for conservative students on campus. As we currently look to cut down on fees that seem to constantly rise and punish students, it is frightening to see that this has been a constant battle. One thing that stood out to me was that both of these articles mentioned the Sharon Statement. I found the statement on the University of California Calisphere Digital Archives. I had never heard of the Sharon Statement before, and found out that it was the founding statement of principles for the Young Americans for Freedom organization, written in 1960 and named after the town it was written in, Sharon, Connecticut. I thought that this quote from 1973 ISU YAF chairperson Becky Borgstrand summed it up well. Basically, the Sharon statement supports the U.S. Constitution, reserves the powers of states' rights, seeks to preserve U.S. sovereignty and international order, and provides for a strong national defense. There was a similar description of the Sharon Statement in the 1991 article, as well as this comment from the YAF National Vice Chairman, Eric Allen Koch. Though these words were written almost 30 years ago, the West is in no less a time of moral, political, cultural, and spiritual crisis. Those 30 years he mentions are 60 years now, and it feels even more relevant today. It makes me wonder about how we view the past and how different we think it is from now. These articles have shown me that even though a lot has changed in the 60 years since the Sharon Statement was written, there is so much that has stayed the same. To end my presentation today, I would like to share a quote from Laura Emery, the current ISU YAF Vice President. I believe the purpose of YAF is to advance conservative ideas on college campuses. Whether advances take place because one conservative student no longer feels alone on campus, or a group of conservatives rallying together to make a change, they're serving the purpose of YAF. YAF has grown substantially in the past 2 years on campus. One highlight was when we brought Andrew Clavin to campus to give a lecture. His lecture drew hundreds of people, some of whom may have never considered a conservative option before. Advancing conservatism, or any cause, is not easy, but it truly is worth it. Thank you.